Your stream quality might be affected.
That's all right. We're not.
Not good.
Not good.
Not for the.
Well, your internet is.
Well,
keeps dropping.
How fast is the internet here?
I don't know.
Here, why don't I give you Wi-Fi off my phone?
I'm on the
now.
Wi-Fi on here.
Yeah, maybe
it's
that's
just not streaming on YouTube.
Go.
There it goes. All right, good deal.
Okay, can we? No.
I gave the mic for efficiency. You can do it too.
Luke, can you start testing the mic?
Hey, I can get the phone.
No, we need to be able to hear the speaker. So I need Luke to talk and hear it from the speaker because that's the most important. So can you walk around the corner and see, make sure it sounds good? Because it'll echo if you're right here.
Why am I not getting a freaking stream?
Does that sound good?
Not even weird.
Here, pull up. So that's. Follow me up here, Nick. Okay.
We know we can hear that from here, but right. We need to be able to hear it from there.
It will hear. Sure. Okay. I just couldn't pick up the stream.
Okay. We're just testing the mic out. Nothing official yet. Okay, pressure's on. We're just making sure everything's set for the live stream for those that aren't able to be here in person. Absolutely. Hold me accountable for it. I have rules. She said she had a fine. Yeah, that's what I was going for.
Is it good?
Do you like this ad or whatever? Yeah, it's like a, it's got a 2-minute
delay. So. Oh, okay. So we can hear it. We'll make him.
I can turn
up the volume
a little bit.
If you wanted it, is that the microphone?
Yeah, but
you
it's.
You can place it closer if you need to.
It's connected to the computer.
Okay. So I can't move it closer.
No.
I can try and scoot a little closer myself then, if that helps.
Do you know how it works, I guess?
I mean, it's just the one button, right?
You have to hold it down.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, might make it a little easier.
Yeah,
so I guess I'll give you a plus action. Hold it down, turn it on, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then when it's on, it's green. Mm-hmm. If you press it again, it'll mute it.
Okay.
So it'll be red.
So. Yeah, we're too close.
All right. So you should be able to pick up the audio better with us over here.
I like to try.
Bride and groom request that during the ceremony that all cell phones be put away. There's going to be plenty of opportunities following the ceremony for pictures. So if you will honor them in this way, it would be greatly appreciated. Gives this bride in marriage. Dearest friends and family, we're gathered here today in the presence of God and in the good company of each other. to celebrate with Matthew and Brittany as these two become one in marriage. We do so understanding that this commitment they make is far more than a legal contract. It's a covenant bond of love that they make today, and they make it on the side of the one who made them, our Father in heaven. If you'll pray with me. Lord, we thank you so much for the way that you've brought them together. We thank you for each of their families who have loved them and built them up into this moment. And Lord, we ask that you bless not just this day, but all the days. If you'll please be seated. What an honor it is to be here today to celebrate with Matthew and Brittany. I've known Brittany for several years now. We've had the pleasure of serving together in student ministry. I was a student pastor at her church in Lubbock. And after meeting her, I knew she would make a great youth leader. For all those that know her well, you know that she loves people and that she's incredibly kind-hearted. She also has a great ability to relate and connect with people and students and come alongside them in everything that they were going through. More recently, I had the pleasure to meet Matthew and get to know him over FaceTime. For those that have been around them as a couple, you know what a pleasure it is to see two people so at ease and so comfortable with one another. I learned something important from Brittany and Matthew as we spoke before the wedding. I got to hear more of their story and what led to this moment today together, but the quality of time. And these two were very intentional in getting to know one another. Many of you may already know, but they met through a Christian dating website, which I found is the story to be true of more and more people. And here's what I love about this story. That these two people who, before meeting anyone at all, wanted this to be known about them, who they were in Christ. That they had an important aspect of their lives, and that was their faith and their belief in a Savior. What a huge blessing it is in this life to find someone who is like-minded when it comes to the importance of faith. Here's what I love most about their story as we spoke. Brittany said this, "I just laid it all out there. I told him everything, all of the good, all of the bad, all of the hurt, and everything in between on in a relationship." I know a good deal of Brittany's story and testimony, and it's a beautiful story of redemption and God affirming to her all of her worth. To listen to Matthew's response to everything that she said, because it's beautiful. He said, "Thank you for being so vulnerable. I've been looking for someone just like you." Matthew went on to share his story with me over FaceTime. He shared the good and the bad and the hard and the hurt and everything in between. He shared his testimony and the way that God had been at work in his life. Turns out his story was one of God's goodness and faithfulness as well. His story was about God's redeeming work in his own life. Guys, I'm telling you, God is faithful and he is good. And surely he is and to be loved. It's a blessing to have found each other and in someone who says, "I'll take all of you." So today you begin an exciting journey. In life you have ahead of you, bad days, weekdays, Saturdays, hard days that won't seem to end, and incredible days that just won't last. All of them days that will come and go too fast. The life you had ahead of you will be filled with many days. They seem countless at the beginning, but the wild truth is there's an exact number of days you will have together. We know this because in Psalms 139 it says, "Every day of our lives is recorded in his book. Every moment is laid out before a single day has passed." My encouragement to you that as you enter into marriage, that you guys will start every day by vowing to love each other completely, just as you will today. You two both stand here this evening, no doubt, because you're in love. And there's lots of ideas and concepts about love. It's often depicted as a roller coaster of emotion with crazy ups and downs, somehow fantastically finishing with a fairy tale ending. And we all want that. We're drawn to the stories, we get caught up in the movies and long for the love. You're called to love one another, but not merely in a romantic way or when convenient, but in a way that makes you sacrifice for one another. That in love, you will each put the other ahead of yourself. Love takes some work and determination. When you sense that feeling, that longing, we have to be careful not to fall for the idea that you can just have it without someone offering it first. True love is a gift, and it must be given first so it's able to be received. You two are offering that to each other today. In 1 John, it says, "We love because he first loved us." And guys, I hope that resonates for you. We love because he first loved us. That as you enter into this commitment, that you never lose sight of how much each of you is loved by the Lord. So how can we do that? Is that even possible? Well, we daily set aside our own desires and dreams, and we decide to put our partner's desires and dreams before our own. You both have to do that. I pray that your days will paint a vibrant picture of love, that each of you will intentionally and purposefully seek to sacrifice for each other. May your affections for each other cause you to share love with everyone around you. I hope people see in you the greatest kind of love, and they are wowed. Guys, I pray that today you enter into this covenant sharing the love of Christ. Love each other lavishly without reservation, and serve each other earnestly. Become lifelong students of one another and learn all the quirks and memorizing all the details that will make the other light up. Father God, give Matthew and Brittany complete knowledge of your will and give them spiritual wisdom and understanding. When the way they live always honor and please you, and their lives will produce every kind of good fruit. We ask this in the name of Jesus. Amen. And now we turn our attention to the vows. The couple has written their own vows, and so if you will turn an attentive ear to them.
Brittany, you came into my life at just the right time when I least expected it. I never thought I would have such an incredible connection with anyone, and fell in love with you after our short time together that weekend. You continue to keep me grounded when I'm feeling down or negative about minuscule items. You have made me aim with you. I vow to be the man that you inspired me to be and the man that you deserve. I promise to love you fiercely and faithfully. I love the way thoughtful and considerate person I know. I have no doubt in my mind that you will make the most wonderful mother to our future children. I vow to wake up every morning steady rock in turbulent times. I vow to put your needs before my own. I pledge to commit myself to our family and the good I know will grow from it. I promise to remember that you're in promise that no matter our finances, health, or place in life, to stick with you through the thick and thin. I promise this all to you until I go to meet our true Father in heaven.
Matt, we stopped to eat breakfast one morning. I had no makeup on, and for whatever reason, you felt it was a good time to take a picture of me. I told you I looked horrible and that you should delete it, and you said, well, what if I want to keep the bad pictures too? Darn it. I was doing so good. Or, I've never had to change or clean myself up for you. You've never made me feel like I was too much or not enough. Oh. You let me sing as loud as I want, even though I can't carry a tune in a bucket. You take me as I am, and you love me unconditionally. From this day forward, as your wife, I promise to submit to you as you lead me and our future children to Christ. I promise to pray first and nag later. I promise to always keep coffee in the house and will do my best to become as good of a cook as your mom. I promise to serve you, love you, honor you, and forgive you as Christ has so graciously done for us. I promise to stand by your side no matter what comes our way. I promise to never stop being silly or trying to make you laugh with my silly puns. I promise to share all things with you. Even my food. Matt, you are a prime example of God's faithfulness. And you've been an answer to mine and my family's prayers. I pledge all of this before our friends and family in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, all the days of our life.
At this time, Matthew and Brittany will pour sand, each using a different color to symbolize the joining and mixing of their lives together.
Your eyes, it's like watching the night sky or beautiful sunrise. There's so much they hold, and just like the moon stars, I see that you've come. How old is your soul? I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you I'm still looking up. And when you're needing your space to do some navigating, I'll be here patiently waiting to see what you find. 'Cause even the stars, they burn. Some even fall to the earth. We've got a lot to learn. God knows we're worth it. No, I won't give up.
Join me as we pray over the rings. Father, bless these rings which Matthew and Brittany have set apart to be visible signs of the inward and spiritual bond which unites their hearts. As they give and receive these rings, may they testify to the world of the commitment that they've made between them here. Amen. Matthew, place this ring on Brittany's finger, and as you do, repeat after me.
Ring as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
And I will love you always.
And I will love you always.
Now, Brittany, place this ring on Matthew's finger, and as you do, repeat after me. Matthew, I give this ring as a symbol of my vow.
Matthew, I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
With all that I have,
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
Audience, if you're looking at Matthew and Brittany, that if you'll stand up for me. And at the end of this, I'd like you to be prepared to respond. And we'll continue to sustain them as they move forward in marriage. They will need you not only today, but for the many days ahead. Each of you, by your presence here today, are being called upon to uphold them, to loving each other and fulfilling the responsibility to one another. Will you surround this couple in love, offering them the joys of your friendship? Will you support them in their relationship? At times of conflict, will you offer them your wisest counsel and the comfort of your concern? And at times of joy, will you celebrate with them, nourishing their love for one another? All those who vow to do so, please respond with, "We will." Thank you. You may be seated. Now that Matthew and Brittany have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, by the power vested in me by our Heavenly Father, I now pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, just as the Lord has brought you together, may He also keep you so that nothing and no one can separate you. Matthew, at this time, you may kiss your bride. If you'll turn toward everyone, and everyone, if you'll stand. It's with great joy that I present to you publicly for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Matthew and Brittany Foster.
Oh, because you are the best thing.
ladies and gentlemen, following the families out here just a moment, if you'll join the wedding party here on the side patio, it'd be greatly appreciated. And so, parents, if y'all will head on that way.
So too.